Well, this has been emotional. None of my tech worked. It took a full reboot of the computer. There's been no warm up. So welcome to Bike Racing Without Mercy. I'm Phil Lovett. This is my quest to win an e-cycling race on Zwift, amongst other things. And today we're taking on 3 hours Tour of Fire and Ice. It's the hilly route to the Alp D'Zwift. And then it's a race up Alp D'Zwift. It's also a race to the base of Alp D'Zwift. I think I switched my bike last night to the Edmonda, which is lightweight, rather than the Tron. Sorry. Right. Thanks, Jane. Sound is good. That's a relief. We've got 54 seconds. No, I've forgotten to eat anything. Well, not forgotten. Didn't have time to eat anything, so really all I've had is lots of water, amino acids, and caffeine. I'm hoping that's gonna be enough because it's about an hour and 10 to an hour and 15 for this race. Good morning, Mr. Duffy. Hope all's well. Or Mrs. Duffy. Will, sorry. Oh, crikey. I'll figure out where I am in the pack. I'm kind of hoping it settles down. Until we get to that first little climb before you get to the Alp. Because I haven't warmed up today. I had a lot of difficulty with the OBS software and the computer. And so I could do with a nice measured lead into the Alp. Coming off the back here, just got to put a bit more power down. Oh God. I Oh, sorry, that was a bit of an emotional investment there. Now yesterday, I raced an outdoor crit, the Cat 4 Full Gas Winter Circuit Series. I was doing all right. Nicely positioned, top three the whole way round really, leading some laps, taking my turns in the front. But then, in the final five laps, I led too many of them. I led about three or four of the final five. Sorry, three. And I blew myself up a bit. And then on the fifth lap, got towards the back of the pack and had up ground to make. And then, as I was making up the ground, one of the riders in front of me slowed on a hill, and I was kind of boxed in. So it was a case of either hit his wheel or bail off. So I bailed off and had a mild crash. I came dead last. Yeah, I'm finding this hard this morning, crikey. Hey David, how are you? Nice to see you. Not sure I'll smash it today. What I'm looking to do is my best possible climb up the Alp itself. Hi Lord, how are you? You're watching a man who's having to ride himself into this. The legs are currently a bit tired. Didn't have a warm up. Not had anything to eat. Nice one, David. I'll be doing that later for some of the other live streams. Thank you, Lord. I am honoured indeed. I know you're a connoisseur of such matters. My power to weight is not going to be of the ilk that we observed last night with Ed Laverack. That was something else, and he was just training. Yeah, it seemed very pleasurable, David, about sitting back and watching other people thrash themselves on Zwift. I really enjoy checking out everybody else's live streams. Niels is a great Zwifter. You should check out his channel. He does some serious long distance stuff as well. Like 60 kilometer races with all the climbs. Yeah. 5, what's a kilogram up the out with a green and blue profile. My Gorby is only 4.9, and that's emotional. This is my first Zwift race again for about 3 or 4 weeks. I like the Alp. because everybody gives it their max effort. Whereas if you do the Innsbruck climbs, when it might be 2, 3 or 4 ascents, some people are just going for a KOM on the first ascent, and that kind of spoils the tempo. Nice one, David. What have you gone for, a Wahoo? I've just bought a Wahoo kicker. I'm one of the machines that simulates the gradient. I reckon it's a little bit harder on a real bike than a watt bike, because the watt bike is more stable and therefore not as much core stabilization. Trax Neo, very nice. That's some top end stuff. Just getting my air blowing towards me. Yeah, the reverse Innsbruck, that's a really hard climb. Do check out, Chris Pitcher will be pleased here, my real life comparison of, I know you probably have, Lord, the reverse Innsbruck KOM in real life versus Zwift. Oh, off the front here. That's not very good. Yeah, the gradient varies from 14% through 3. Yeah, the Alp. It's almost like an FTP almost. And so I'll be aiming at really, hopefully, 270 watts up the climb average. I weigh in at 65 kilograms at the moment. So just over 4 watts, probably 4.2 watts a kilogram would be lovely. Yeah, hook it up to Zwift, David, and join us in a race. Fuck. All right, we're coming to the nasty bit now. I always hate this little hill more than the Alp itself. Partly because it's a real fast, punchy climb, and I'm not a real fast, punchy rider. And partly because, you know, you've got the full Alp to go. Trying to kind of recuperate a little bit here. I'll be hoping to ride the intermediate pre-climb at about 300 watts. I'm using a Watt Bike Atom, Lord. It's really good. It's what's got me into cycling. I bought it about a year and a quarter ago, August 2018. It's got me fit. I love it. But I do reckon, having started riding a lot more outside and looking at my power data outside, and also occasionally on holiday on indoor trainers attached to a proper bike, it is a bit harder on a normal bike because of the stabilization. Yeah, nice one, David. Get into condition and then we'll race. Are you still riding outdoors a lot at the moment, David? All right, here we go. There won't be a lot of talking here. I hate this. Let's get the momentum. Dropping through the gears, spinning as much as I dare. Oh, Jane, thanks. Yeah, can you bring me a full fat Coke? I was gonna ask. I've got it on training difficulty 75%. That simulates a 32 cassette on the rear, in my experience, including when I did climb Alp D'Zwift for real. I was able to sit and spin. Cheers. Team car has just delivered one full fat Coke. Oh, sorry, I wasn't really concentrating there. Hey, Patrick. This is hurting. Trying to get onto the blob here in order to make the descent to the foot of the Alp easier. It's costing a lot of energy. Cheers, Joe. God dear. Oh, very red profile. I will pay for that. She does it gratuitous. What is Rogue Brand Tours, Patrick? Brompton to the station. Better than nothing, David. Keeping your eye in. Get turbo training over the Christmas, sorry, over the winter, and your fitness will go woo. Yeah, I should have stayed in. Lord, that killed me. Again, poor race tactics. Now, having invested, I sure as hell better stay in this blob on the way down and try and recuperate. Oh, crikey. How's it going, Joe? Nice weekend. Heart rate's coming down, all right. Jane's gone to the gym now. No more team car support. Yeah, Jane, wise words from the gym. Oh, God. Hey, Niels. How are you today? Nice. Yoga's good for the mind and the soul, as well as the flexibility, Joe. I'm going to ride my own race up here, up the Alp. If I try and follow the 5 watts a kilogram people, it will be miserable. And the time a lot slower overall. We'll see when we get to the actual Alp, Niels. I reckon you didn't see it, but I had quite a nasty chase to get back onto the blob. And as Lord quite correctly pointed out, that was not strong racecraft. Should have invested earlier. Yeah, even mid fours is going to be beyond me. Lord, I think somewhere in the 270 to 275 range, I'll be happy with, 4.1 to 4.2 watts a kilogram over the whole race. So probably a bit higher on the Alp itself. I'm going to let the diesel engine kick in and ride myself into the climb. Well, that's what I'm hoping. Yeah. That's the intent, Niels. Accelerate a little on the lower incline hairpins. And my comparison of Alp D'Zwift versus Zwift in real life should be out next week. Fingers crossed. I've got 2 videos, 2-parter. Let's get your heart rate down. Oh, here we go. The meat and potatoes. And by the way, I do not have a poker face in the mountain. The grimacing will be unpleasant. Here we go. KOM starts now. Just trying to settle myself here. Many of the steeper gradients come at the bottom. It's really easy to burn yourself out on the first two corners. Yeah, try to focus, Jane. Thanks, Lord. Very early in, though. Try to keep the cadence high. And the box, the match is boxed. Drop the gear too low. Accelerate. Just keep the graph yellow and orange. I'd love to do that, Niels. That is the intent, but hard to do. Just focusing on the breathing and the cadence here. Not chasing the wattage. Thanks, Niels, I'll look out for that. Yeah, totally. That's what I figured you meant, Niels. Yep. That's a good caveat, Lord Delega. Oh dear. Yeah, me too. The last time I swam climbing the Alp, it was an over and under training session. Unders at 4.5 watts a kilogram. And the overs outnumbered the unders. Feeling okay today. Hate for the chlorine to be back. Sorry, it's a boring race. I'm hoping people start to wilt and the diesel engine here brings them back in. Yeah, 7.2 for 12 minutes. Wow. Nah, I've got it down at 75, Paul. Mimics a 32 cassette on the rear. That's what I used when I climbed Alp D'Huez in real life. Just investing it here on the 14%. Pennails. Yeah, it was funny though. Chris Pritchard on the out. I salute you, Chris. Thanks, Niels, that's what I'm hoping. Cheers, Lord. Keeping it measured. Thanks, Jane. Wise advice. I think he's a cat B. He's putting down good power. Cheers, Paul. It really helps. All the encouragement. Thank you. I still find the drinking difficult when you're around threshold. Yeah, on my full gas circuit yesterday outside, my heart rate averaged 175, peak 185 for the full 45 minutes. Haha, wish that was beer. Just got to dig in here. Bring the heart rate down, Phil. Wow. That is light. Japanese though. Hi AS, thanks for joining. whoever he is, this is a good duel. Sometimes it's almost easier just to race your own pace than hold the wheel in front. Much appreciated, AS. Oh yeah, thanks Jane. That's a good point. Sorry, just burnt myself out there. Famous last words earlier. That's my carbs gone. Just investing here. Thanks, Jane, will do. Director Sportif on the radio with good advice. Oh, feeling it now. No, no, it's helpful to communicate, Joe. Takes my mind off. Other matters. Will do. Oh. This is a nice tactic, Niels. Much appreciated. Yeah, it does a bit, Lord. It's nice reading the comments as well. Hey Dean, good to see you. Thank you. Hoping to reel in the guy in front. Or the lady in front. I need them to blow up though. Yeah, just try to do the lantern rouge advice. Keep the mouth open. Suck in air to the diaphragm. Oh yeah, I always forget. Please remember to like the video. I know everyone here is a subscriber, but if you watch it in replay, please do subscribe. I'd very much appreciate it. Still 6 kilometers to go. That's miles on this. Nice one, Dean. How old are your kids? I've got a 17 and a 16 year old. It was a bit of an emotional start to the race, Dean. Ah, but still a nice age. Teenagers, that's harder. I'm not saying, you'll find out. Although boys are better than girls at teenage years. Isn't that true, Joe? Of my kids. This is hard here, trying to get back on his wheel. I think he may have given up, not sure. No. I'm sure it's difficult, I guess, to stop and start on the reel out. Oh, nice one, Dean. How long are the trail runs? In Scotland, I take it. Yeah, he stopped all of a sudden, Lord. He's got back going now. At a decent pace, too. Beautiful. That's a nice place to do trail runs, Dean. Oh, thanks, Niels. Appreciate you rejoining. Hey, Mark. How are you? They're all right, actually, today. Thank you. No worries, Niels. It's always good to see you. Yeah, thanks, Lord. that's what we're kind of aiming for. It's a horrible pain face. Sorry to hear you got the flu though. Everybody mark the cycling smo. Sorry, the cycling smo has started a YouTube channel about his quest to go from Cat D to Cat B. It's really cool. He just won his first Cat D race in the crit last week. Nice one. Well done, Mark. I've not yet won a race on Zwift. You look pretty handy on a bike though, Lord. What kind of racing are you doing at the moment? Dark place here. Yeah, we'll do, Joe. Trying, Jane. I'm starting to wilt a bit. I'm being caught from behind. Thanks, Lord. Thanks, Joe. Will do, Lord. And my reward, I catch up with Jay Stevenson. Yeah, try to stay positive, Jane. Cheers, Lord. Oh, crikey. Wow. Wow, that felt good. Happy with that. I think that's my fastest time up the Alp. 1 hour, 10 minutes and 9 seconds. In terms of the Alp and the fire, Tour of Fire Ice Hilly route to lead in. Thank you all. Oh, I'm super pleased with that. My watts per kilogram are in line with those that did better. Give me a second. It's going to go to a different course just to cool down. No, thank you all. Thank you all ever so much. The encouragement in the chat really makes it a hell of a lot easier on the climb. almost kind of threshold efforts, which is basically what that was, you know. I don't think I dipped below 270 other than one stage where I was 268 the whole way up. And I reckon my average up the climb would have been around 272 to 275. Because obviously I was off the power a fair bit on the descent down to the Alp itself. Oh, that's a great place. And thank you, Lord. Bear me a second. Oh, let's have a look at the Zwift power. Yeah, I was wondering how well I was going to do today, because I was feeling a bit jaded when I woke up this morning. Here we go. So, here we go, 3 hour tour of fire and ice. Yeah, 7th. That'll do. I'm only 5 minutes. 5 minutes. Off James Gelsthrop, who's a Cat A plus. He averaged 268 watts and 4.5 watts a kilo. My normalized power isn't up yet. But yeah, that's super cool. And Niels, I know you're not watching, but that's a great tip there to change up a gear as you hit the, or up a couple of gears as you hit the hairpins and really double down on the power, because you definitely carry a fair bit of speed into the actual ramping up of the gradient. And I reckon that all contributed to what is a time, it's probably about 2 minutes quicker over that entire race than I've ever achieved before. Yeah, 1 hour, 10 minutes and 20 seconds. Oh, Spider-Man, yeah. I suppose I do look a little bit like Spider-Man. No, look, and really appreciate everybody tuning in. Oh, so James Gelsthrop, let's have a look at his weight. Oh yeah, yeah, 59 kilo. Yeah, Velo One. Is Velo One a hill climbing club or something? And then we have Kei Takashi, 4.6 watts a kilogram, and he was in at 57 kilos. And then from Norway, Kim Jakobsen, 70 kilograms and a whopping 318 watts. And it's amazing, you know, the power, you know, 70 kilograms plus people can put down. There's a guy called Rob at the Full Gas Winter Circuit Series yesterday. It was his first ever Cat 4 race, and he got a beautiful Specialized bike. But he was weighing in at 92 kilograms, he told me, after the race, right? And he must have been putting down, like, I don't know, 400 watts or something like that, because I was rarely below sort of 230 to 260 watts through the crit. But he dragged everybody around it. And obviously, he cuts a big sort of slice through the air that you can follow into. It was really hard to get around him. I think big power guys on the flat and the descents, obviously, they can dominate, but to get up Alp D'Huez in a time like that, weighing 70 kilograms with power sustained at 318 watts, 4.5 watts a kilogram, you know, full respect to Kim. Novik, let's have a look, Novik. Oh yeah, Jean-Philippe Gassner, 4.1, yeah, again, Jean-Philippe. Yeah, he was the person I was gradually reeling in. But 318 watts, insane. You know, these guys on the crits will absolutely destroy people on the sort of the flatter crits. No, thank you very much, Lord. Yeah, yeah, I kind of lost concentration at the wrong moment there, and yeah, that is a fault of mine. I kind of drift out of the draft, and then, you know, you expend a lot of energy to get back on. I wondered how good the climb was going to be as a result, but it was actually all right in the end. It woke the legs up. Anyway, unless there's any other questions. I really massively appreciate everyone tuning in. Please remember to like the video. And if you watch this on replay and you haven't seen it before, please do remember to subscribe. Plenty more live streaming and obviously health and fitness, the fat loss series will continue. And I'm also gonna merge into racing outdoors, albeit in the UK, you can't film on the bike. So I'll be looking to do some crits elsewhere. I did one in Miami while I was away. Anyway, to the connoisseurs of What's Revolutions of BPM, please do check out my stats on Zwift Companions, Zwift Power and Strava. And in the meantime, please remember, whoever you are and whatever you do, live, thrive and subscribe. And now the stream ends.